So there's a lot of different ways they can ask you about rate of change, but really all they're getting at all the time, right, is rate of change is how fast something is moving or how fast something is changing. Automatically we can get that from slope, which now that we have all the Calc 1 tools, or the Calc 1 tools we have up to this point, we have derivatives. We can use the derivative as usually the fastest way to get the slope or the rate of change of something. So in this particular problem, they give us the height of an object in meters, t seconds after an experiment begins. They like to do these ones a lot, because if you think about what they end up looking like, if you drop something under gravity or you throw an object, right, they usually kind of follow some kind of path that looks like, or like a rocket launch, right? It could be anything. They usually look something like this. This particular one, if you graph it, you notice also like the point 0.08 is on there, right? It's not the vertex. It's a little bit more on the up. Maybe I should here make my drawing a little more accurate. Maybe if 0.08 is here, it does something like this. And so this one must have been starting at some kind of height, right? So it means that the time t equals 0 seconds, it was already at 8 meters, and then it went up, and then it started to fall down. And if you were like further looking into it, you don't need to for this question, but if they asked like, when does it hit the ground, you'd be looking for when is the height zero. That appears to be like 4.70156 seconds, so in the air for less than 5 seconds. All right, but their question is, how rapidly is the object moving 7 seconds after the experiment begins? So right here, we're at time t equals zero, so their question is, apparently this one maybe, I don't know, the height's gonna go negative. It's not a big deal. Maybe it's like falling into a canyon, or maybe we're measuring it starting at some point, or it's out in space or something like that, so we can get like below the spaceship, I don't know. But they're asking about what happens way out here at 7, comma, in fact I could find the point at 7, I guess, if I look at my graph. It's not super important, but like at 7 we're somewhere close to, just to get an idea between this and this in the actual what the question's asking for, somewhere close to like negative 20 meters. So like negative 20 point something. All right, but their question isn't where is it, right? They don't want to know the height. They want to know how rapidly is the object moving. So that's something different. They want to know the rate of change at 7 seconds. So we want the derivative when h is 7. So first step would be, if we just find the derivative, right, what's h of t in this? All of a sudden the screen was having a hard time picking up my pen. There we go, h of t. So derivative of negative t squared is negative 2t. Derivative of 3t to the first is just 3. So it looks like our derivative looks like this. And then their question is, how fast is it moving at 7 seconds? So we just put 7 in here. And it looks like negative 14 plus 3, which is negative 11. Then we want to throw some units on it, right? And also, notice this is velocity versus speed. So speed, we could say, oh, I'm going 11 miles an hour. If you're going 11 velocity, the only difference is if you're going 11 miles an hour up, it's plus 11. If you're going 11 miles an hour and you're losing, right, there's direction in velocity, then it could be negative 11. So it's okay to have an answer that's negative. So it's negative 11. Since this was originally in meters, this is negative 11 meters per second. So how rapidly is the object moving? So anytime they ask about speed, they're basically asking about the slope or derivative.